Hello, my name is Sarah Lou Petcher, and I'm one of the attorneys here on staff at NVAR, and I would like to talk to you today about the new forms changes which are being released January 1, 2016. There are three main changes we're going to address today. The first change deals with the regional sales contract. In the top paragraph of the regional sales contract, rather than having the term buyer broker to describe the person representing the cooperating broker in the transaction, the Standard Forms Committee has changed that term to cooperating broker. We had received feedback from the membership that the term buyer broker may be misleading, since sometimes the buyer is actually not represented by anybody and may be acting as an independent contractor in the transaction or maybe a sub-agent of the listing agent. So that's the first change you're going to see in your regional sales contract. And that change will be carried through all the other forms as we update them. So for some time, you will have both buyer broker and cooperating broker in your forms, but as we update them, the term buyer broker will disappear. The other changes you'll find in your regional sales contracts are in the form of clarifications. There is no other substantive changes that you'll find in the regional sales contract. We have clarified the change we made to accommodate TRID implementation in the last quarter of 2015, and we also have clarified the financing terms for alternative financing. So moving on to the second form, the other change that you find is in your contingencies and clauses addendum. That change was made to the paragraph, the contingency on seller purchasing another home. This change was made to clarify the contingency and allow more flexibility for the seller to sell his home. The old language used to be interpreted to mean that as soon as a seller was ratified for the sale of his, purchasing another home, he had to remove the contingency in the current contract, where in reality, the seller may have wanted to wait a little bit and get through his home inspection contingency on the purchase of another home before removing this contingency. So we've allowed more flexibility for the seller and changed the term to seller has identified another home for purchase. Hopefully this will smooth out transactions and clarify any misunderstanding between the parties. The last change is essentially a revamp, an update of your buyer's limited access to premises agreement, also known as your decorator's agreement. This form hadn't been updated since the mid-1990s and was in need of a complete overhaul, which the Standard Forms Committee did. The form was updated. It now has allows access for two purposes, to measure rooms and windows, doors, and such things to get estimates from contractors, and to allow the buyer to deliver and store furniture when the parties agree to that. There is a date for the access. There is limitation on what the buyer can deposit in the property without specific permission from the seller. And it clarifies that the buyer will remain responsible for any damage or loss to the property while it's being stored in the seller's home. And it also addresses what happens to the property, what happens to the personal property of the buyer that he has delivered to the seller's home when the contract falls through. And it gives the seller permission to dispose of it as they wish if within 15 days of the death of the contract, if you will, the buyer hasn't come to pick up his personal property. If you have any more questions on our forms changes, please go to nvar.com and submit your question to the legal hotline, and we will be happy to assist you. Thank you.